The classic Jets Fighter Museum at Parafield has announced it's winding down after more than 20 years of wowing aviation fans. The volunteer-run organisation will auction off its extensive collection of war artefacts, including two jet planes that have been carefully salvaged and restored.
It's a house of history honouring our heroes of the sky, but the classic Jets Fighter Museum is preparing for its final flight.
Time's come to move on. We've been open to the public for 23 odd years. All the troops are getting a bit long in the tooth.
Robert Jarrett has been pilot in command since day dot, curating a collection that's now set to go under the hammer. Among it, this Royal Australian Navy sea venom that cost the museum more than $10,000 to restore.
Flew for HMS Melbourne, our last aircraft carrier in the 60s. It was a very successful airplane, well loved by its pilots, was very safe.
And this unmissable 1960s Jindavik.
These were flown in Woomera as test rockets. They were radio-controlled, pilotless jet aircraft.
Robert is hoping items sold at the auction will fetch enough money to help him finish one last project. A Corsair he salvaged from a lagoon in Vanuatu where it crash-landed in 1944.
It's our last aircraft. It's very impressive and we can't quit that.
All these artefacts reflecting the work of dedicated volunteers who have poured their heart and soul into the museum.
A lot of volunteers over the years, many hundreds in actual fact, and a lot of them came from Centrelink, working with unemployment benefits, and they stayed on after that wound up because it was part of their life.
Hopefully the collection will go on to other museums and won't be lost, but yeah, it's a sad day.
If you've always wondered what it's like to sit in the cockpit of a fighter jet, well, there's still time. The museum will remain open for a few weeks after the auction, which takes place on July 24.
I'll have to have a bottle of whiskey on the side there somewhere waiting for me.
Lucy Hinton, Nine News.